Do you remember this story, the man on the road of, to Emmaus? Like in Luke chapter 24:32, they said to each other, "Didn't our hearts burn within us as he talked with us on the road and explained the scripture to us?" Ito yung dalawang lalaki na they're walking, right? And then suddenly God walked with them, right? And they said to each other, "Didn't you hearts?" That's why the scripture said, they said to each other, "Didn't our hearts burn within us as he talked with us on the road and explained the scripture to us?" So, my friend, as a Christian, we have to walk with Jesus. We have to talk with Jesus. That's what these two men, right? You have to listen to Jesus. You have to share our experience, the love of Jesus, to others. You have to share His word. This is what the people who were to, walking the Emmaus did. They walked with Jesus. That was seven miles from Jerusalem, right? And they were talking with Him, and they listened what He was telling them. And finally, they shared the Jesus experience with others. If we walk with Jesus, talk with Him. You know? Listen with Him and share Jesus with others like the people of Emmaus. We will grow and be fruitful in life if we do that. Areas in which we are to love the Lord supremely, all of our mind. All of our mind. A love for God is not a mindless love. We are to love the Lord because we have considered Him and meditate on Him and His greatness. We must make conscious choice to love the Lord. We should love God because we were taught to, or even because it is the right thing to do, but because of who He is and what He has done for us. Amen? Our thought should center on Christ. Areas in which we are to love the Lord supremely, all of our
strengths.
This refers to the fact that this love is not only in word, but in action. Okay? I repeat again. This refers to the fact that this love is not only in words, but in action of our physical body. Dapat nasa gawa, di ba? We must love the Lord with everyone, with every ounce of our being. We truly love the Lord. He will have prominence in every area of our life. True love for Jesus manifests itself in every area of our area of life. Do you love His people, His word, His house, His work, His word, His commandment, and His worship as you should? And the example in the Great Commandments, that is in Mark 12, Mark 12, 31, and the second is like namely this: thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than this. So as like what I said, these two commandments are intertwined. You cannot have one without the other. They're always together. So how could you love God without loving people? You know, you can only share what you have. If you don't know how to love, how can you love other people? Love your neighbor as yourself. Yes, love them as you love your very own self. That's what the verse said. It's a good picture to show how much you love them. Right? Love your neighbor as yourself. Yes, love them as you love your very own self. This is a good picture to show how much you love them. but be selfless and love them even if they don't love you back. That's what God love us, unconditional. Right? What? Are we worthy to be loved? No. We are sinners. We're not worthy to be loved. But God loved us so much. He gave His only begotten Son to die for us. Right? If there is a way you don't want to be spoken of, don't speak that way to other people. Right? Loving the brothers and sisters in Christ and serving them selflessly will show the word.